So here we will learn about JMeter listeners. So JMeter listeners are the reporting elements in JMeter where we can create and view the reports of our test. And here JMeter listeners or listeners in JMeter are used for reporting, and these are the elements that gather information about the performance test, and we can use it to view the results and metrics of our test. So let me go to my JMeter, and this is the test we created in the earlier session. So we have a thread group where we have 10 users, ramp up period is 20 seconds, and let me say the loop count is 1 here. And then if I go here, this is my HTTP sampler that I have named my first HTTP test, and here it is going to this lifecharger.org and going to this page 2-minute rule. And in the earlier session, we already saw two listeners, that is view results in tree and view results in table. So the listener, the main listeners we are going to see are these ones. Let me copy them here and you will get all these notes as well. So view results in table is what we are going to see first, and we have already added this. So to add a listener, you just have to do a right click on your thread group or maybe your test plan and go to add. And here you can go to listeners and you can see all these listeners are here. So let us first see view results in table. So here this is my listener, and we know that to clean or clear the listeners, we use this clear or clear all button. So clear all will clean all the listeners that you have added in your test plan, and clear will only clean the results from the selected listeners. So this is already clean, and now I will start my test and let us see the output here. And now you can see I am getting the sampler results here, and we should be getting 10 sampler results or 10 results or 10 rows here, because if I see in the thread group I have 10 users and the ramp up period is 20 seconds. Let me say users 5 and the ramp up period also 5 here. This will help to run the test quickly. Now we have got our results in the view results table. Let us study this listener. So the first column is sample number, and you can see there are 10 samples. Then we have the start time for every sample, and this is the thread group name. So this is what is the name that comes from here. This is our thread group. And then here you will see a label. Also, if I expand this, before going to the label, let me show you this. In the thread name, you will see thread group, which is coming from this name. And then you will see these numbers 11, 12, 13. This means that this is the first iteration for first user. This is the first iteration of second user, first iteration of third user, and so on. Suppose we have more users or we have multiple requests, you will see duplicate entries for every user. And then this is the label that is coming from our request, that is my HTTP test. And then here we have the sample time. So this one is the time taken in milliseconds. Let me expand this and show you. So this is time taken by this sample in milliseconds. And then we have a status. Now if you have not added any assertions, status will only be checked against if you have got a valid response and 200 status or any successful status. Otherwise it will show as a failure. And if you add assertions that we will learn in the coming session, then it will be also be based on the assertions that you have added. So in this case everything is pass, and then you will see bytes. So this is the size of the response, this is the byte sent to the server, and now we have latency here. Latency is again in milliseconds, and what exactly latency means is, let us say if I take a scale from 0 milliseconds to, let us say, 2000 milliseconds. Now let us say here we sent our request. By the time request went to the server, it was 1000 milliseconds, let us consider. And then from 1000 milliseconds we started getting the response, and then we got the complete response at 2000 milliseconds. Now here this point where we started getting the response will be the latency. So this will be latency, that we started getting the response at this particular time, but the complete response we got was in 2000 milliseconds. So the sample time will be 2000 milliseconds, but the latency time, that is the time when we started getting the first byte of the response from the server, will be 1000 milliseconds. So this is what is the latency time. In simple words, we say latency is equals to time to first byte. And I will highlight this. So this was latency, and then you will see a connect time here. So the time it took to connect to the server, this is that time again in milliseconds. And then you will see a field where you can browse a file, you can read or write these results to a XML or a CSV file, and you can also upload the results from that file. We have a configure section where you can configure the headers and other properties. So this is view results in table. Let us now see view results in tree. And you can already see, if I go to view results in tree, I already have this results here, and this is how it is shown here. For every sampler result, you will see this tree, and if you select anything, you will see the sampler result. You can see here the response code is 200, okay, and the body size, headers, sent bytes, latency, everything you will see here, connect time, load time. And then for a request, the request body and request headers, and for response, response body and response headers. Now you should not use this listener when you are doing your actual performance test. This listener, view results in tree, and any other graphical listener or any listener that shows you a lot of data and information is good when you are creating your test case and or debugging your test cases. When you are doing your actual performance test with thousands or hundreds of users, you should disable all these listeners and should have only simple listeners that give you tabular data. Or when you run from command line, that we will learn in the coming sessions, you can just use a CSV file to log all your reports. So you should not use this listener when doing actual performance test. And to disable, you can just do a right click and disable from here. Again, you will see a field name field here where you can write or read results from a file. Then let us go to aggregate report. And for this, I am going to add the listener, which is called aggregate report. And for now, let me clear everything and I will run my test again, and let us see the output now. So you can see in view results tree and view results table, you are getting all these report, but if you see the aggregate, you are getting a single line, and it depends on the number of samplers. As of now, I have a single sample or a single HTTP sample, therefore I am getting a single line, and this is basically a average of the all the samples for that particular request. So if you see in view results in table, we had one row for every request of the sample, but in aggregate report, we will see an average of all the samples. So here we can see an average time. Again, it is in milliseconds. We have a median. Median means this is like a middle line. So half of the request took less than this time and half of the request took more than this time. Then we have 90% line. That means 90% of the response was within this time. That is 6449 milliseconds. Then we have 95 and 99% lines similarly. And then we have maximum time. You will mostly find that the 99% line and the maximum time has more or less the same time. So 99% of the requests were under 7382 milliseconds, and that is also the maximum time taken. This is the minimum time taken by any request in all the samplers. If there are any errors, you can get the error percentage. This is throughput and this is per minute. So this is number of requests per minute metrics. And then we can see received data or size, and then send data or size here. So this is kind of an average of all your requests per sampler, and you can again use a file to read and write here. The next report we are going to see is graph results, and this will be interesting. Let me create and add the listener that is called graph results, and here it is. And to see some data here, I'm going to go to my thread group, and I will increase the number of users here and also increase some ramp up time and make it infinite so that you can actually see some data. Now also make sure when you are doing this, if you are learning JMeter and if you are doing it on your own system, do not give a very high count of the users, like 100 or 2000 or 5000. We also need a system with an infrastructure that can handle that load. So therefore, we create separate environments for performance testing, and I will tell you about that later. But if you are using your own personal system, do not increase the load more than 10 users or 20 users, and also keep it for one or two iterations. Just for this demo, I am doing it infinite. And now if I clear and run my test, you will see some data coming here. So you can see some red dots are here and some blue dots and green dots. Let me go and change the look and feel of JMeter so that you can see this very clearly. If I say Windows, yeah, now you can see it very clearly. You can see some dots here and there are different colored dots. So here you can see the key. Here, green is for throughput, red is for deviation, purple is for median, blue is for average, and black is for data. And if you want, you can also check or uncheck something from here. So I do not want to see data, I do not want to see median, I do not want to see deviation, I just want to see throughput and average. Also, you will notice that when you start your test, you will see throughput is more and average is less, but very soon you will see these lines coming together and also crossing each other sometimes. And that is because as you send the same request to the server over and over again, the server develops cache memory, and therefore the next request takes less time. So you can see it is now crossing each other. So this is how it is performing. You can see this graph here, and I will have to shut it down or stop. I have already shown you and told you what is the difference between shutdown and stop. If you want to shut down gracefully and want to stop all the threads before stopping, you should use shutdown, and for abrupt stop you can use stop button. Now it is stopped. I will go back and change the loop count to 1 and also change my users to 5 and ramp up time to 5 seconds. Also, this is a graphical listener, so you should not use it when you are doing your actual performance test. And now let us see a summary report. I will add a new listener, and this is called summary report. And now if I run my test case, you can see a summary report listener here. And again, you will see here we have got this single line where we have one row per sampler, and it is something similar to what we saw as aggregate report, but you will not find this 90% line, 95% lines, all these here. You will only see the label, that is whatever name is your request has, number of samples, the average time, the minimum and max time taken, standard deviation, error percentage, throughput, received and sent data, size, and average bytes. So this was a simple summary report. Then we have simple data writer, and let me show you. I will go to my thread group, right click, add listener, and we have simple data writer here. And you will see here we do not have any graphs or any table here. We only have an option to add or send these results to a file. So here, let us say I create a file. I will go to my desktop, and let me say I will create a simple CSV file. I will say here report and make it CSV. So you can see I have added this file, and now I need to go to its location. So let us say this is on desktop, or I can directly browse it from JMeter. I will go to my JMeter and I will say browse, and I will have to go to my desktop. And yes, my file is here. I will say open, and let me just try this. I will now run my test and see. I will run my test case. Okay, so it is asking me to give a new file. Let us say I give it reports1.csv, which is not already existing. And now I will save and run, and let us see now. So here I can see the progress, and it is still running. Once this is completed, I will check. So now the users are ramping down, and yes, looks like this is done. Now I can see the other listeners. All these listeners have data, but now I will go and check my reports1.csv, which got created here. You can see I have got all these data in my CSV file. So we have timestamp, elapsed time, label, response code, and let me show you all these columns. We have timestamp, elapsed time, label, response code, response message, thread name, data type, success, failure message, byte, sent bytes, group threads, all threads, the URL of the request, the latency time, idle time, connect time. So these are the details we can get in the file. Of course, you can do the configuration from JMeter. You can go to configure and you can select what all fields you want to get in the file. And this will be a good option to use when you are running your actual performance test, because it is directly adding it to a CSV file without using any JMeter memory here. So these are the most commonly used listeners in JMeter. Let me see if there is anything else we can see here. So if I go to listeners, we have summary report. You can see all the summary, aggregate graph, assertion results. So assertion results listener will show you the results of your assertions if you have added any assertions, and we will learn about this in the coming session. Then we have summary results, then mailer for if you are using any mailer, sampler, then you can directly use save responses to a file. We have already seen simple data writer, and then if you are using any scripting of bean shell sampler, you can get a bean shell listener as well here. So these are the top listeners that we use in JMeter. I hope this was useful. Thank you for watching.